Hello everyone. Now today we are here to do an experiment from the class 10th physics. Aim of this experiment is to determine the resultant resistance when two resistors are connected in parallel. When we say that two resistors are connected in parallel, when one end of all the resistors is connected to one common point and other end of all the resistors is connected to other common point, then that resistance are connected in parallel. Now the formula to calculate the resultant resistance when number of resistors are connected in parallel is reciprocal of resultant resistance is equals to sum of reciprocal of all the resistors that are connected in parallel. This is my apparatus arrangement to find out the unknown value of the resistance. Here I have joined the positive terminal of the battery with the positive terminal of the ammeter. The negative terminal of the ammeter is joined with one terminal of the unknown resistor. The second terminal of the unknown resistor is joined with the one terminal of the rheostat. The voltmeter is connected in parallel with the unknown resistor. Here we have joined the one terminal of the resistor with the negative terminal of the voltmeter and the other terminal of the resistor with the positive terminal of the voltmeter. The next terminal of the rheostat is joined with the one terminal of the one-way key. The second terminal of the one-way key is joined with the negative terminal of the battery. Let's start the activity. First of all, we will find out the least count of the voltmeter and ammeter that we are using here. Least count of the operators means the measurement done by the one division of that operators. Here the voltmeter that we are using having 10 divisions is equals to 0.5 volt. It means one division is equals to 0.5 upon 10 and it is equals to 0.05 volt. Similarly, the ammeter that we are using in our activity having 10 divisions is equals to 0.5 ampere. So one division is equals to 0.5 upon 10 is equals to 0.05 ampere. So the least count of our voltmeter is 0.05 volt and least count of our ammeter is 0.05 ampere as I have shown you in our voltmeter and ammeter. Let's find out the zero error of our voltmeter and ammeter that we are using. Zero error means the reading shown by our voltmeter and ammeter when the rheostat is at the zero position. Here, the error shown by our voltmeter and ammeter is above zero, so we will add the zero error in our observation. Now, let's calculate. In our voltmeter, the number of divisions shown by the voltmeter is 11. It means it is the zero error for our voltmeter. And the number of divisions shown by our ammeter is 4. So it is the zero error for our ammeter. The zero error of our voltmeter is 11 divisions into least count of our voltmeter, that is 0.05, and it is equal to 0.55 volt. The zero error of our ammeter is 4 division into the least count of our ammeter, that is 0.05, and it is equals to 0.2 ampere. Now to take the first observation, I will adjust the position of the rheostat to make a particular value of the current in the ammeter. Now I have adjusted rheostat so that the number of division in the ammeter is 10. And corresponding to it, the number of division in the voltmeter is 23. Let's note down the observation for the first resistance. I have named it as R1 resistance. Now, the reading of the voltmeter that I have observed was 23 division into the least count of the voltmeter, that is 0.05, and it is equals to 1.15 volt. Now, to find out the corrected reading, observed reading, that is 1.15, plus the error in the voltmeter, that is 0.55, and it is equal to 1.7 volt. Now, the reading of the ammeter was 10 division into the least count of ammeter, that was 0.05, and it is equal to 0.5 ampere. Now, to find out its corrected reading, observed reading, that is 0.5, plus the error in the ammeter, that is 0.2, and it is equal to 0.7 ampere. Now, to find out the resistance, we will use the formula R is equals to V upon I, that was given by the ohms, and we will get resistance is equal to 1.7, that is the reading of the voltmeter, upon 0.7, that is the reading of the current, and it is equal to 2.42 ohm. Now, to take the second reading, I will again adjust the position of the rheostat to get the value of a current. Now, I have adjusted the rheostat so that the ammeter reading is 15 divisions, and corresponding to it, the reading of our voltmeter is 33 divisions. Now, this is the calculation for the second observation, from which we have got the value of the resistance is equals to 2.31 ohm. Now, again, I am adjusting the position of the rheostat to get a value on a ammeter. You can take any value of the current in the ammeter. I have adjusted the position of the rheostat so that the number of division in the ammeter is 20 divisions, and for it the number of division in the voltmeter is 43 divisions. In the same way, we have done the calculation for the third observation, by which we have got the value of the voltage 2.7 volt, the value of the current 1.2 ampere, and from these two values we have got the resistance 2.25 ohm. Now, we will find out the mean of these three values of the resistance, then we will get resistance R1 is equals to 2.32 ohms. Let's do the next part of this activity, in which I have replaced my first resistor with another unknown resistor. Now, to find out the resistance of this unknown resistor, I have made the arrangement in the same way as we have done for my first unknown resistor. Now, The least count and the zero error of our voltmeter and ammeter will remain same because we are using the same voltmeter and same ammeter. Now again I will adjust the position of the rheostat to get any value on the ammeter. I have adjusted the rheostat in such a way that the reading in the ammeter is 10 divisions and corresponding to this current the reading in our voltmeter is 24 divisions. Let's do the calculation for the R2 unknown resistor in which the first reading of the voltmeter was 24 divisions into the least count of the voltmeter, that is 0.05 volt, and it is equals to 1.2 volt. To find out the corrected reading, we will add the zero error in the observed reading. It means 1.2 plus the zero error in the voltmeter, and it is equal to 1.75 volt. Now the reading in our ammeter was 10 division into the least count of the ammeter, that is 0.05, and it is equals to 0.5 ampere. To find out the corrected reading, 0.5 observed reading plus the zero error, that is 0.2 ampere, and it is equals to 0.7 ampere. Now to find out the resistance for the first observation, we will use the formula R is equals to V upon I. Our voltmeter reading is 1.75 volt divided by the current reading, that is 0.7 ampere, and it is equals to 2.5 ohms. Let's take the second reading by adjusting the position of the rheostat. I have adjusted the position of the rheostat so that the number of division in our ammeter is 15 divisions and corresponding to it the number of division in our voltmeter is 33 divisions. In the same way, we have done the calculation for the second observation and we have got the value of the resistance is equals to 2.31 ohm. Let's take the third value. For that, I am adjusting the position of the rheostat so that the number of divisions in our ammeter is 20 and the number of division corresponding to it in our voltmeter is 44 divisions. In the same way, we have done the calculation for the third observation by which we have got the value of the voltage 2.75 volt, the value of the current 1.2 ampere. By these values, we have got the resistance is equals to 2.29 ohm. Through these three values, if we will find out the mean, then the mean value of R2 is equal to 2.36 ohms. Let's discuss the operator's diagram in which R1 and R2 resistors are connected in parallel. Here, the positive terminal of the battery is connected with the positive terminal of the ammeter. The negative terminal of the ammeter is connected with the one terminal of the R1 resistor, one terminal of the R2 resistor, as well as positive terminal of the voltmeter. Now, the negative terminal of the voltmeter as well as the second terminal of R2 resistor, second terminal of R1 resistor is connected with the one terminal of the rheostat. Okay, so here the common point that we have taken is the negative terminal of the ammeter as well as the one terminal of the rheostat. Now, the second terminal of the rheostat is connected with the one terminal of the key. The next terminal of the key is connected with the negative terminal of the battery. Let's discuss the circuit diagram for it. Here, the positive terminal of the battery is connected with the positive terminal of the ammeter. The negative terminal of the ammeter is connected with one terminal of the R1 resistance, one terminal of R2 resistance, and positive terminal of the voltmeter. The negative terminal of the voltmeter, the second terminal of R2 resistance, the second terminal of R1 resistance are connected with one terminal of the rheostat. The second terminal of the rheostat is connected with one terminal of the key. The next terminal of the key is connected with the negative terminal of the battery. Let's take the first reading. To take the first reading, I am adjusting the position of rheostat to take a value of current in the ammeter. You can take any value. I am adjusting in such a way that the reading in the ammeter is 15 divisions and corresponding to it the reading in the voltmeter is 14 divisions. Now the first reading in the voltmeter was 14 division into the least count of the voltmeter, that is 0.05, and it is equals to 0.7 volts. Now to find out the corrected reading of the voltmeter, observed reading, that is 0.7 volt plus 0 error in it, that is 0.55 volt, and it is equals to 1.25 volts. Now in the ammeter, the reading was 15 division into the least count of the ammeter, that is 0.05, and it is equals to 0.75 ampere. To find out the corrected reading, observed reading, that is 0.75 plus 0 error, that is 0.2 ampere, and it is equals to 0.95 ampere. Now to find out the resistance from these two values, we will again use the formula V upon I. So we will do 1.25, that is the reading of the voltage, divided by 0.95, that is the reading of the current, and it is equals to 1.32 ohms. Now to take second reading, we will again adjust the position of the rheostat. I am adjusting the position of the rheostat in such a way that the reading in the ammeter is 20 divisions and corresponding to it the reading in the voltmeter is 19 divisions. In the same way, I have done calculation for the second observations by which I have got the reading of the voltmeter is 1.5 volt, reading of the ammeter is 1.2 ampere. When I will use these two values, then I will get the resistance is equals to 1.2 ohms. Now to take the third reading, I am adjusting the position of the rheostat. I am adjusting in such a way so that the reading in the ammeter is 25 divisions and the reading in the voltmeter is 25 divisions. Now, in the same way, we have done the calculation for the third observation by which we have get the value of the voltage is equals to 1.8 volts and the value of the current is 1.45 ampere. When I will use the formula to calculate the resistance, then I will get 1.24 ohms resistance. Now, to find out the mean from these three values of the resistance, we will add these three values and we will divide it by 3, that is the number of observation. When we will add 1.32, 1.2 and 1.24, then we will get 3.76 and the number of observations are 3. So we are dividing it by 3 and when we will solve it, we will get 1.25 ohms. Now, if we will use the formula by which we can calculate the net resistance when two resistors are joined in parallel, then the formula is 1 by net resistance is equals to reciprocal of the first resistance plus the reciprocal of second resistance. Now, the value of first resistance is 2.32 ohms. So, when we will put the values, then we will get 1 by 2.32 plus 1 by the value of the second resistance is 2.36 ohm. So, 1 by 2.32 plus 1 by 2.36. When we will solve it, then we will get 0.431 that we have get by solving 1 divided by 2.32 plus 0.423 ohms and we will get 1 by R is equals to 0.854 ohms. Now to calculate the value of R, we will do the reciprocal of 0.854, then we will get 1.2 ohm resistance. So, the value of the resistance when two resistors having the value 2.32 ohms and 2.36 ohm connected in parallel is 1.2 ohm. This we have calculated by using the formula and this is the value of the resistance that we have calculated with the help of experiment. So, the value of the resistance when two resistors are connected in parallel, experimentally we have calculated 1.25 ohms and with the formula we have calculated 1.2 ohms. The conclusion of this experiment is that within the experimental error, the experimental value of the resistance when the two resistors are connected in parallel as well as the value of the resistance that we have calculated by using the formula is approximately same. So this verifies the formula to find out the resistance when the number of resistance are connected in parallel, and it is equals to reciprocal of the equivalent resistance is equals to the sum of the reciprocal of all the resistance. Thank you so much. I hope this activity is clear to you and you have enjoyed it a lot.